Jeremiah chapter 1. God is about to bring light into this ministry and into the life of every individual. To see if God will touch your life. Everybody needs God in his life. Everybody needs a touch of God in one way or the other. Praise the Lord. It will be a shameful thing that God came and he didn't see you. Amen. Is anybody with me? It will be a shameful thing that God came and he didn't see you. Could it be that God can come yet people will not see him? Is it possible that God can come yet people will not recognize that this is God? So one of the dangerous things that will happen to every man is to miss God when God comes looking for him. No wonder Jesus said, I stand at the door of your heart to knock. That if anyone opens, maybe somebody may not know that this is God knocking. Is anybody with me? So it takes a spiritual perception for somebody to know that this is God knocking. And if he can open, he promised to come in and see God coming in no matter. Have you heard amen from somebody? Say, I will not miss my time. I will not miss my target. I will not miss his promise. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is bringing liberation into this ministry.
Yes.
We can't just be less. Amen. We can't be less. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 8. He said, do not be afraid of them. Somebody need to be courageous. Somebody need to summon courage. Somebody need to assume his position, knowing that he has never given us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of sound mind, boldness, amen, to tread upon snakes and scorpions, to take what belongs to us, praise the Lord, to live long on this earth, to be prosperous, because what I am looking for, someone else is looking for it. There are so many competition out there. People are using different kind of means and powers. Amen.
Amen.
But I refuse to follow their style. You know why? Because he has told me not to be afraid of their faces. Anytime God said, don't be afraid of their faces, there is something about somebody's face. Sometimes you see them using your brother's face, using your senior brother, using somebody, using people that are dead, you use their faces. And you see them in your dream, you see them in your different areas. Amen. And sometimes you start calling, Pastor, where are you? You dream my dream last night. I don't understand. Don't be afraid of their faces, said the Lord. Because if you quit from being afraid, God will give you victory.
Amen.
I see somebody who will celebrate victory after now.
Amen.
I see someone who is celebrating things after now.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Be not afraid of their faces. For I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. I am with you to deliver you. I am with you to give you victory. Is a capital failure. Pride will make you say, nobody should lay hand on me. Pride will make you say, nobody should talk to me about my family. Pride will make you say that I don't need anybody's help. Pride will make you say, it's better I stay in my house and pray to God to answer me. Foolishness is a junior brother to pride. When somebody is foolish, it is demonstrated with pride. Is anybody with me?
Yes, sir.
And I can tell you that every foolish man is a child.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to find the characteristics of foolishness, look into a child's life.
Mm-hmm.
A child of 3-4 bones, we put him into the fire. If you hurt him, and then you will go back again to put again, you have to come and rescue the child. You know why? Because that child is demonstrating foolishness. God is a good one because he's a child. A child That is foolishness. But it is okay with a child. But when an adult refuse to grow out of foolishness and then become mature, then it is no longer a natural thing. It has become a spiritual manipulation. Because one of the dangerous enemy or dangerous weapon the enemy uses these last days is to make you foolish. Because a foolish man thinks that he's okay. Is anybody with me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Any man that is foolish will always think that he's okay. Don't tell them, no, you are. They will argue. They will tell you that this thing you're saying is wrong. And you will try to give him some points, some proof. See what he has happened to. See the person, see how it happened. Then the person will still be arguing, saying it can't be possible. Tell the foolish man that people go to the moon. They will ask you, have you gone before?
That is it.
When a man is foolish, he doesn't know it. He will think he's right.
When
a woman is foolish, she doesn't know it. Leave that boy that you have been sleeping with, that don't pay your dowry. Don't follow him again. He will use you and dump you. He said, no, husband's castle, this one I go back home and well. When foolishness attacks you, he makes you not to reason well.
That is it.
Foolishness is an attack.
It's an attack, yeah.
People are not just being foolish because they want to. It's an attack. He said, be thou not afraid of your faces, for I shall deliver you. One of the areas that God is delivering his people in these last days is to deliver them from foolishness. If you look into the word, now go to social media. If there are 2 comments or 5 comments, 3 is about the church. Because the devil has put foolishness in the life of people. The gossip pastors, the gossip church, the talk down in the things of God. People no longer, you know, get afraid of God anymore. Because when foolishness attacks you, it makes you look equal with somebody that is older than you.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you see somebody who is foolish. We call his father as Papa. Even if you say my Papa, for saying you the animal. You have already called him an animal.
You already called him an animal.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Foolishness. And this thing is very rampant in the church. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now hear the language of a foolish man. You were sick. The Bible said the man was a captain. Neman.
Neman.
He has defeated so many countries.
Nations.
God has given them, he given him victory. Anytime he back on any war, he comes back victorious.
Yes.
But he was a leper. He had everything. But when I hear the story of that man, then I knew that the reason for his long-term leprosy was because of foolishness.
Yes,
foolishness will make your miracle delay.
That's it.
Foolishness will make your miracle stay long.
Okay.
Foolishness will make you watch people celebrating while you are still folding your hands. Okay. Because when they were doing what you are doing, you think they were foolish. You are the one that is actually foolish. Now when they did it and they are testifying, you fold your hands and say, if I had known. For if I had known is always the last language of a foolish man.
Tell us.
May you not be foolish.
Amen.
To miss your own portion.
Amen.
May you not be foolish.
Amen.
To miss heaven.
Amen.
Because very soon Jesus will appear. Only the foolish ones will say that is no God. And when you say there is no God, you will not believe God.
Yeah.
That is what the Bible says. He said, only the foolish says there is no God.
Wow.
Do you know how they say it? The Bible said they didn't say it with their mouth, they said it in their heart. He said, in their heart they say that there is no God. Then how did they know that they said it when they didn't hear them saying it? Because your character.